Children, today we are going to start with a new chapter, that is chapter 4, Simple Equations. We will start with understanding what do we mean by equation. I'll try to explain you in a very simple and easy manner. Let us start. Children, you must have heard about these two terms, constant and variables. Yes, in class 6, you have done your chapter algebra. There I have explained you the meaning of constant and variables. Let us revise it first. We have two terms. One is called as constant. The other is called as variable. Children, constants are those terms which are fixed, which do not get changed in the equation. Take for example, 4 minus 4, 20 by 3, or 1 by minus 17. It can be any type of value, even decimal value. But the value is fixed, it will not change. Let us take one example. If I say, I have 2 chocolates. I have given you the value that I have 2 chocolates. So will it become 3? Will you think it is 10? No. The meaning is 2 because you know ma'am has told us the number. So numbers are the constant values. Then what are the variables? They are just the opposite of constant values. That it will keep on changing. They are not fixed. Let me give you one example. I said I have 2 chocolates. Okay. Now suppose I say I have X chocolates. So you must be thinking, ma'am, how many chocolates you have? Ma'am, please tell. One child came. I said, okay, you take value of X as 3. So the child, what she is doing? I said, I have X chocolates. Now children came to me. Ma'am, tell us how many chocolates you have. So where I have written X, I am telling the child that the value of X is 3. So the child will put the value of X as 3. Replace X with 3. So child will say, okay, ma'am, you have 3 chocolates. One chocolate you will share with me. Children do not ask, but children, you know, teachers generally, we share with you. Sometimes when you put something good, we give you chocolates. So this is how this child came, and she came to know that I am having 3 chocolates. Then she went with one chocolate. She said, yes, ma'am gave me one chocolate. I did my work. Ma'am was very happy to see my neat work. I'm just giving you an example. So one more child came running. Ma'am, please tell how many chocolates you have. I'm giving you just an example. This doesn't happen in the classroom, you know. Okay. So now I said, I have X chocolates. She said, ma'am, please tell me the value of X. I will understand. This time I have changed the value of X as 1. So now the child understands that ma'am is having only 1 chocolate. This is one thing. Let us make it more interesting by understanding with another example. Now children said, okay, ma'am, if you have X chocolates, we have twice of your chocolates. These type of questions were discussed in class 6. So we will bring the previous knowledge and understand. What is the situation now? That if I have X chocolates, you are saying that ma'am, if you have X chocolates, we have 2 times of what you have. So that means if I have 2 chocolates, so the children will have 2 times of X. Times mean multiplication. So 2 into 2. 4 chocolates. I will say, oh, you have 4. That means I also have 4. I will change my sentence. I will say, no, I have 4 chocolates. Then you all will say, okay, ma'am, no worries. If you have 4, you will see. This is constant. This will not change. And this is times. I will explain in detail about this also. But still, you know, 2x means 2 into x. So now you will put the value of the variable and now see the answer, it is 8. So every time when you're putting the value of the variable, so what will happen in the equation, the values will get changed. This is the meaning of variables. Now, from constant and variables, what we can do? Take for example, I have constant value 4 and I have a variable x and I plan to add it. So what will this become? 4 plus x. Somebody will say, no ma'am, don't add, you multiply. So I will say, okay, 4 into x. So 4 into x is 4x. Got it? Or you will say, no ma'am, let us divide. So 4 upon x. Or you can say x minus 4. Anything you do with constant and variables. That is, what anything? What is it? Anything here, children? Anything here is the operation on the constant and variable values. So we get these terms. These are terms. Is it clear? Have you understood? And combination of many such terms. For example, 4x minus 3 plus 7x. This will become your expression. Constant and variables combined together, do some operation on it, you get the terms. See here, what expression it is, sorry, what term it is. It is simply 3 into 1, or you can say, we do not have any variable in this term. So it is okay. This is a constant term. These are the terms, but this is the constant term. Clear? But still it is a term. So when you combine constant and variables together, you get terms. And when you collect many such terms, what is this? You get an expression. And when you equate this expression with some number, it is called as an equation. Any number you can take and equate. This we will get in the question. We are not designing the question, but I'm just trying to give you some examples to make you understand what is the meaning of equation. Is it clear? That from the combination of terms, you only get expression. And equation is always followed by an equality sign. So this is the equality sign. And then it becomes your equations. Now, in class 7, we will simply learn about simple equations. These are the simple equations. Because otherwise, as you move ahead, in senior classes, you will come across variables. Here we are simple means, here we will deal with only one variable. One variable. Like in this question, we have x. So it is one variable, same variables. Same variables we will be taking and solving and getting the answer for the equation. Okay. Children, now we will learn how to solve these equations. I will not tell you the direct method, whereas today I will discuss one story which is created by me years back. And if you have elder sisters at home or your friends who are senior to you, to whom I have taught, they will immediately understand that if ma'am is teaching simple equations, ma'am will definitely tell you fox story. The first thing is, you should know that we need one method which is called as transposition method. This method. Children, this method, transposition. This method helps us in solving the equation and getting the value of the unknown variable. This is all in this chapter. There is no formula, no rule, nothing. Only one concept you have to understand, that is called as transposition method. And you will be thinking, ma'am, you gave us the example of an equation. But what we have to do with the equation? Take for example, 4x minus 13 equal to 20. This is an equation. The question is to find out the unknown variable. This is what we have to do in this chapter.